have 16 major books in the Odu Ifá literary corpus. There are 240 minor Odus, which means we have altogether 256 Odus in Yoruba land. Now, how many have we talked about on Tales of Odu? Anyway, not to bother you too much, we are learning some new things again today on the program Tales of Odu. My name is Opejemi Orimolade, and I have with me Oluwo Dr. Fatunde Fayemi Ifakayode. You're welcome onto the program again today.
Good day.
Now, we'll be looking at Ilawo generosity on the show today. So, Oluwo,
thank you.
What Odu, or how many Odus talk about generosity?
Thank you. First of all, we cannot precisely say how many Odus talk about generosity.
Okay.
Because if we look at the Odus, we can even say in many Odus that we can have something about something that has to do with generosity.
Okay.
Because in many verses of Ifá, we can say in all Odus, we have something about generosity. Because okay, even a Eboriru sacrifice is all about generosity. If one is stingy, you cannot make Ebo, because you will not want to spend your money, you will not want to spend your time, you will not want to sacrifice anything that belongs to you, to maybe to another person or to an unseen spirit. That means Ebo is all about generosity. Making Ebo itself is generosity. But in Ogbe Otura, which can be also be called Ogbe Alara, and that is why some people they call it Ogbe Elegiri. Why they call it Ogbe Elegiri is because of generosity that it talks about. According to the Odu, the verse says, Iregerege awo regerege regerege awo regerege. Adwa gun olofin moju egun so gbere omo igba ti obi obigun igba ti obi obi akala igba ti obi obi tentere igba ti obi obi elegiri awon mere ni won so mo olofin igi kan igi kan lowa yadina ni popo lowe. The verse is talking about olofin who has four children. He has igun, the vulture, akala, the grand hornbill, tentere is another kind of bird, and elegiri. According to the verse, Olofin gave them money, which is was igba oke each. Igba oke can
be like 200,000
or 200 cowries. Then it can be like saying 200 million now, as they are maybe like an inheritance given to them. The money that was given to Igun, Igun was somebody who liked pounded yam a lot. Yeah. He was using the money to buy pounded yam to eat. And whenever Igun was eating, even if he had friends around him, he would not give them part of the food. He would just prepare food for himself, not to give to anybody. The same thing with Akala. He liked taking oka and akala, who eat alone without giving to anybody. Tentere was somebody who like interesting, maybe of any kind of animal. Whenever he wanted to eat, we just say, like many people nowadays, when they get to any canteen, they say, you have a pounded yam, then give me intestine, like a liver or any kind of tinuera. They call it tinuera. That was the kind of person that Tentere was. And whenever Tentere was eating, he would also eat alone. But Elegiri was a very generous person. He would use his money to buy wine, like the kind of oti that we have in Yoruba land then was otika, which was made of guinea corn, shekete, which was made of maize, agadagidi, that one was made of plantain, and emu, the palm wine. Elagiri always uses his money to buy wine and will give to everybody. That was why in the verse, it goes thus, wọ́n fi gbọ́ ọ̀kẹ́ fógún ikún fowó tí ẹ ṣíyán ó nìkan ṣoṣo ló fi jẹ́ wọ́n fi gbọ́ ọ̀kẹ́ fákàlà àkàlà fowó tí ẹ rọ́kà ó nìkan ṣoṣo ló fi jẹ́ wọ́n fi gbọ́ ọ̀kẹ́ fún tẹ̀ǹtẹ̀rẹ́ tẹ̀ǹtẹ̀rẹ́ fowó tí ẹ ra fún ó nìkan ṣoṣo ló fi jẹ́ wọ́n fi gbọ́ ọ̀kẹ́ fẹ́lẹ́gìrì ẹlẹ́gìrì ló fowó tí ẹ rọ tí ọfẹ́ gbé ayé mu ọfẹ́ gbé ọrùn mu that is 200 cowries was given to Igun. Igun used it to buy pounded yam. He ate it alone. Akala, his own 200 cowries, he used it to buy oka. He ate it alone. Then Tere used the money to buy intestine.
And he ate it alone.
He ate it alone. But Elagiri used his money to buy wine and he gave to all his comrades, even the heavenly ones. Mm. That is when you give something to your friend, you have given to your earthly comrade. And when you use part of it for maybe sacrifice of any or anything spiritual, you are giving to the heavenly comrade. And there was a time there was a problem in the city. There was a tree, and the tree they fell on the road, and they were inviting them one after the other to solve the problem, to remove the tree. They called on Igun the vulture. Igun could not remove the log of wood because it was very heavy. The same thing with Akala and Tentere. But when it was the turn of Elegiri, when Elegiri got there to try to remove the log of wood on the road, before he even touched the tree, many people have come to support him.
His character
and,
has come.
Yes, instantly they removed the log of wood. And they said, Elegiri eyan ti logun. Elegiri eyan ti logun. That is, it is a lot of people that can fight war and be victorious. Eyan ti logun. You cannot fight war alone. You cannot struggle alone and be successful. You have to do with assistance of people. You need people's aid. You need their assistance, so that you can achieve whatever you lay your hand on in your Tilogun. We can see the lesson that Ifá is trying to teach us about generosity. Because Igun was stingy, and that is why he was unable to remove the log of wood, and he was unsuccessful. But because of the generosity of Elegiri, many people came to assist him, and he was able to solve the problem for the whole town. Looking at the issue of generosity in Ifá, even in Ogbe Irete, which is the next Odu to Ogbe Otura, we could see that it is very dangerous for somebody to be stingy, and we have to be generous always. And even people that we call the stingy people that we call Ahun, you can see that they always have problems. When they have problems and they want to solve it, people are not always ready to assist them. And because the Odu tells us about the issue of Alabaun, the tortoise.
Okay.
That when Alabaun, according to the Odu verse, goes thus, Àwọn gbọ́ àwọn lòun fún tọrọ amúsùn àṣírí ohun tó ṣàmúsùn àtẹ̀kùn lẹ́sẹ̀ gba owó ribiribi làwọn ti gbé san. Adífáfá lábàáwọn àjàpá ń tọrun bọ ayé dífá fún ọ̀run mi láti ń tọrun bọ wáyé. That is a stingy man to himself or herself is very wise, and that is why he will not give his things to people. I will always use it alone. But the person that is generous, many people will be looking at them as stupid people. That see this one, see how he's spending money. Apa. They say, Apa, Amuswa. But if I say that he is not stupid, that is, if there is a problem, if the stingy person is spending a lot of money to solve the problem, the generous person can solve it without spending a kobo. Because people will say, don't you know him?
He's been helping us,
philanthropist, this and that. That was the declaration of Ifá from Alabaun the tortoise when he was coming from heaven.
Okay.
When he was coming, And you go to the boundary, and that is where everybody will just go and say, this is what I want to go and do on the planet Earth. And Orunmila was with the only body.
I choose that destiny. Day.
Yes. And Alabamun just said, as I'm going to the planet Earth, when I got there, I will not be generous at all. I will be stingy, even to the people who want to assist me. If anybody should say I should bring something, like money, mm-hmm. I will just cut it down to the 16% of it.
Wow.
And give to the person, and I would lie to the person that I don't have anything.
Wow.
More than that. And Orunmila was there listening to what Alabamun was saying. And on getting to the planet Earth, Alabamun, one day he went to Orunmila, and as Orunmila saw him, he remembered, this is the man who said so.
That you'll be stingy on
him. Yeah, no problem. And Orunmila, what Alabamun came to Orunmila for? Orunmila was supposed to collect 60 cowries from Alabamun to solve all the problem. And Alabamun said, I have come to receive blessing. And Orunmila said, blessing cannot be received all together. You have to take it one by one. And he said, but if you want to receive blessing, bring 16 cowries. Immediately, Alabamun said, I don't have 16 cowries, I have only one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Orunmila said, okay, bring it. And he did something for Alabamun to be healthy. Then Alabamun was healthy, but he didn't have wife. Whenever you came across any woman, say, I'm planning to, I want to marry you.
No, I can't marry
then
you.
Then he went to Orunmila. I have been finding it difficult to get wife. Orunmila said, bring 16 cowries. Let me do all these things for you. Alabamun said, I have just one. Orunmila collected one cowry.
And that's two cowries now.
Yes, did it for Alabamun. Mm-hmm. Then Alabamun, now he has wife. But the wife was unable to...
To be pregnant.
And he went back to Orunmila. Orunmila said, bring 16 cowries. Then Alabamun said, I have just one cowry. He said, bring it. Then he did something. The wife became pregnant. And later, the wife was having problem to deliver when
she was in labor.
Then he went to Orunmila. My wife is in labor. Orunmila said, bring 16 cowries. Then I have just one. Then Orunmila collected, did something. The wife delivered. Then he said the child was sick, went to Orunmila. Later, my business, I am having problem with my business. Bring 16 cowries. I have just one. Orunmila will collect. Then Alabamun, instead of paying 60 cowries to do something for him to have all good things of life. Now he was paying one cowry, and he even spent more than 100 cowries to achieve all good things.
Imagine that.
You can see. How, if one is stingy, how it is dangerous for the person, and if one is generous, that is why Epo is even all about generosity. That is why, if I say, Orunmila was telling Alabamun, Baba, like your megba, wa esu eso, la fi geni opalaun, that is, if you want to have money, bring one cowry, no problem, and you collect it. It's bit by bit that you collect things from a stingy person. That you can see how generosity is good and is beneficial to someone, is advantageous. And to be stingy is something that is not advantageous to anybody.
From Alabamun's story now, do we have any other Odu, that talk about being generous?
Yes, that is why I'm saying it's even almost all the
you mentioned
generosity. When they say go and make so able, let's see for instance now. When they said Irete Ogbe,
okay,
first says ole bere bere ole bere bere ole bere oro te de di okokoro gba ko gba ko adivabaja card ti se baba adan njo to gbagbo lode orun. They said Adan should sacrifice a ram to his father, the spirit of his father, to have all good things on earth. Then Adan said, how will I sacrifice ram? I don't believe that. And he didn't, and he was unable to achieve great things. Then later, he had a dream himself. He saw his father sitting, and he saw fortunes, the spirit of fortunes the spirit of Aje Web came to his father that, "You Ajakade, tell your child Adam on earth to sacrifice a ram so that me, riches, Ajay can go to him, because I've been trying to go to him, but there is a kind of blockage. If he should sacrifice that ram, the blockage will be removed." Then when Ajay went away, the spirit of wife came, said the same thing, "Child, all the fortunes." Then in the dream, Adela got the information, the message to sacrifice about 20 rams. See what this thing
has caused him. Instead of sacrificing one ram.
Yes. Now he has sacrificed, he has to sacrifice many rams now. And to be generous, at times, when you look at it, even within the family, it is dangerous. If one is stingy, it is dangerous for the wife, if it's a man. And it is even dangerous for the children. And even if it is a mother, because when you look in a family now, somebody may want to be generous and the wife may be telling him to be stingy. Even a wife may want to be generous and the husband will be saying no to it. There is a story in Ifá where we have somebody that has to do a sacrifice. I mean, that has to do something that when the person did sacrifice, the animals for the sacrifice has to be
distributed
to people around so that there won't be problem. And Ifá is telling us that whenever we are doing sacrifice, it is the mouth of people that you sacrifice to Enola and Bonife. And when you make sacrifice, even when you are doing something like your birthday, marriage, naming ceremony, and you don't give food to the people, the community, that is being stingy and it's dangerous, because that person will not receive the blessing that is supposed to be received. That is why when we are doing any kind of party in Yoruba land, we say give food to the people of the community. That is that about generosity.
Now, you kept on talking about sacrifice, Ebo. What's the importance of Ebo in, you know, everyday life?
Thank you. When we are talking about Ebo, Ebo is a Yoruba word. But when we look at it in English, we can say offering or sacrifice. And Ebo is of different nature. There is Ebo that you can make with animal, like killing a goat. There is Ebo that you can make with money. There is Ebo that you can make with your time. That is why Ebo is very, very important in one's life, in everyday's life, because even when you send your child to school, the money you pay as school fees is Ebo that you make, because you sacrifice that money because you want the child to be successful in life. You know, there are many people that will have the life, they will have the money, but they will be stingy to pay school fees of their children. They say, this school is too expensive. Let me take my child to so school, which is less expensive, less costly, because they don't want to sacrifice money. And some people, they are not ready to sacrifice their time. Because even when you go for family meeting, you have sacrificed your time to make something.
To have communion with your family.
Yes, in the family. Even when you create time for your children, to talk to them, to teach them, you've sacrificed your time. Some people, because of their business, they say, "I have to be in my shop now." Even wives, "I have to be in my shop." They will not prepare food
for their husband.
For their husband. They don't want to sacrifice the money that they are supposed to gain for a certain period of time, maybe for an hour or 2 hours, to prepare food for the husband. Is difficult for them. And once you can't do that, there will be problem, because you have not sacrificed the time that was supposed to be sacrificed, so that there will be no problem in the family. Everything we do in life, like the time we create for something, the money we spend on ourselves, on our children, on the husband, on the wife, they are all part of Ebo.
All right, I'd like to say a big thank you again to Oluwo, Dr. Fatunde Fayemi Fakayode. But like I used to say, I tell you that in Kometa, Unode Okimpa, Ode Ipaso, Ode Ipofo, Ode Padanu, Ani Paso, Ani Ipofo, Ani Padanu, Bubara ni ni chef ni chef ni chef ni
chef
ni chef ni chef ni chef ni chef ni chef until some other time when we meet again on the program Tales of Odu. I'd like to say a big thank you to Yomi Adibo, Michael Ajayi, and of course my guest on the program, Oluwo Dr. Fayemi Fakayode. My name is Opejemi Orimolade. See you next week.